Hey Jerry, this is Colton at North Island Nissan with that quick walk-around video on the 2007 Nissan Murano that we have here. So I do want to show off the hood first of all. There was a little bit of frost on it this morning, so half of it sort of wet. I tried to kind of clear it off as best I could. But yeah, hopefully it shows up in the camera okay. The hood's definitely faded, so like if you look down below, if my shadow's not in the way, the bottom part here does have that kind of metallic shine to it, whereas it just sort of loses the shine on the hood. It kind of has it around the edges a little bit, and then as soon as you get to the center, it kind of just goes to more of a flat color. I'm not exactly sure why. The biggest point to see would be right about here. The shininess is still kind of coming through, but you can kind of see the rest around it is a little bit faded there. I really hope you can see it okay on the camera. I know it's not the easiest thing to capture there. I can try again later in the day after this hopefully dries out as well. But yeah, you can kind of see it right in there. Hopefully it shows up okay there. But other than that, the rest of the vehicle is in great shape. It does have the aluminum alloy wheels on it. If we take a look down below, there's the fog light inserts right down there. And so, of course, it doesn't actually have the fog lights in it, just those little inserts to be able to do it aftermarket. It does still have the roof rails up top if you were looking at putting any kind of racks up top there. Now I'll just kind of do a walk around the outside, and then I'll give you a good look at the inside as well. That's all-wheel drive. It does have the bumper protector here. Looking at the inside, we got our power locks, windows, and mirrors. And then I did mention when I was talking to you over the phone, it does have a power seat to it here. And it's all in good shape. You can see the seats do match as well. The exact same material on both of them. And then I'll show you the back seats real quick as well, just to show you the condition of those. Oh, one of them's folded down there. Maybe fold that guy up real quick. There we go. So yeah, all in good condition there. I don't believe there's any tears or anything like that in the seat. There's an armrest that folds down in the center console here. Do you get that guy? And then I'll show you a couple of the features on the interior. So again, power seats for the driver's side. Show you the key here real quick, just a basic key. Alright, there we go. So on the left-hand side of the steering wheel, we have some radio controls to the volumes on the top. And then you can change the sources with those buttons there. On the right side is our cruise control, bottom button to turn it on, down on the little switch to set, and then up to resume if you hit the brakes or cancel. And then I did mention it was a US vehicle, so there's 103,849 miles on it. Comes to just over 167,000 kilometers. And the kilometers are kind of on the inside of the dial in there as well. Something to keep in mind when you are driving it. It does have the screen up front, which, holy smokes, I can't see it at all with the sun there. Pretty much on that, it has your radio information and the temperature controls as well. So it shows you exactly what temperature you're set at. And that does relate to the dual climate control as well, because you can set two separate temperatures. Some computer information right down below that. So you got the trip information, fuel economy, the hour and minute for the clock, and then the trip reset as well. Going down below is our radio controls. So pretty straightforward there. Your CD player is right up at the top. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 different presets for the radio. This one will dim the screen up there as well for the day and night setting. And then below that's the climate controls. So you get all of your different modes. You get your front windshield defroster, rear windshield defroster, air conditioning. Temperature dials are on the left and the right for each side of the vehicle. And then your fan strength is shared in the middle. And then you have the gear shifter down below. There is the all-wheel drive lock down there, and that's where the power mirrors are as well. And then the gear shifter, you get all sorts of little pockets in here. Everything kind of opens up. You get your cup holders. Closes up nicely. Armrest. The armrest is a little faded as well, worn out a little bit. Try and show that off. But yeah, overall, the vehicle's in really good shape. If there's anything I might have skipped over rather quickly that you did want to see, just let me know. I'll be happy to make another video or even take a few pictures for you. But I hope you enjoyed this video and have a great rest of your day. Goodbye.